Explain to us briefly what is happening with the provision of funds for education for members at the moment.
Well, the Department of Military Veterans is expected at least to dispense about 11 benefits and service to military veterans. Mm. One of those speaks to education support. Presently, we are supporting about 8,018 dependents and military veterans. But we are at least facing with challenges in terms of the next academic year, which is 2019, when it comes to funding.
So traditionally, where has your funding come from?
Well, our funding comes, of course, from the National Treasury. Mm-hmm. So, but we must do proper planning, and then we must at least submit those to National Treasury for approval. Mm.
So what has happened since then?
Well, the demand for education support from the beneficiaries has gone up. So unfortunately, we've got to keep up with the demand, which is getting higher. Mm.
So if you are unable to get more money, if you're unable to squeeze more out of Treasury at this point, what is your next move? What is the plan B? Do you have a plan B?
Yes, of course. We must have a plan B. Plan B, we are engaging as we speak our sister department in terms of demand of basic education and higher education. Mm. And we are also engaging National Treasury. We are engaging, of course, through the Department of Higher Education, NSFAS. The idea is we are going to encourage, and we are encouraging the new applicants to approach, especially for tertiary education, to approach NSFAS for support from that direction. And also we are engaging the Department of Basic Education to looking at free education schools, so that we can encourage also our beneficiaries to approach those schools. And we are also going to be engaging in the issue of, is it possible from government to exempt from paying fees these dependents of military veterans? Mm.
So
this is what we're busy with as we speak.
So for those who aren't familiar with the program, Derrick, just tell us, I mean, is this sort of like military veterans who have dependents that go back to what age? I mean, are we talking higher education? Are we talking from grade one? Are we talking even before that? Does this include grandchildren? How far back does it go?
Well, the definition of military veterans includes the people who have been involved in the liberation struggle from the ANC, MK, from the BAC, APLA, from AZANLA, and the SADF and TVVC armies. Mm. Now, if you look at those, they've got children. Some are still at basic education level. Some are still at tertiary level. But with the present SANDF, you've got also what we call the MSDS. Now, those are the ones who come in and serve for 2 years. They come at the age of 18. Therefore, they finish at the age of 20, 22. They become military veterans. Mm. So if they want to go to tertiary education, they are entitled to go to tertiary education. But for the older generation like myself, then we talk of our kids, but not necessarily our grandkids.
Yes. Okay, so you know, if there's anybody who's skeptical outside this morning, Derrick, just thinking, you know, why should we have to support military veterans for kids who you know, who they haven't really done anything or haven't really fought? Yes, their parents have. We understand there are some success stories. I mean, these kids go on to do great things. If you can remember just off the top of your head, you know, some who have been supported by this program and have gone on.
Well, since we started about 5 years ago, we have at least able to claim that we have succeeded to have about 140-something of those students graduated at university level. Mm-hmm. And among those, we've got a medical doctor. So that tells you that they are success stories.
Mm. Okay, well, that's great. Any potential meetings? And I see here that there's going to be road shows happening to talk to military veterans and dependents about the challenges. So are you also engaging with military veterans to ask them if they have any ideas as to how they, you know, to find contributions to this program?
So when we came to realization that we are faced with this challenge, one of the things we at least have felt that needs to be done is to engage the South African National Military Veterans Association. Mm-hmm. That association includes the various associations of the formation which were involved in the armed struggle. They are represented there, so they are part of the solution to the problem we're faced with. We are also, the Minister of Defense has got a council which advises here. So that advisor council is also engaged. So we've created an integrated team to look at this challenge, how to move forward.
Okay, well, we look forward to hearing your progress.
And I will be moving also to the various provinces where we'll be talking to our stakeholders, including the parents and the dependents, so that we can explain to them what is the future.